But we're gonna edify you predominantly on the Puerto Rican, so-called Puerto Rican, to show you your true heritage. Why the so-called Puerto Rican? Because a lot of you think you're American. A lot of you think that you're so-called white, okay? And you're not. That's the doctrines that America has put out to you, okay? America has you believing that you are a thing. Why do I say a thing? Because a Puerto Rico means rich port. How can you be a thing? How are you a rich port? The land is rich, or was at one time before the so-called white man got there, okay? But this ain't about a hate campaign. Let me stress that first and foremost. This ain't about racism. This is about who you are according to the Bible, okay? This is about your true nationality of who you are. When you look at the word racism and break it down, basically it means love for your people. We got love for our people. This is why we out here where our people live, explaining to them who they are according to the Bible, and explaining to them the laws that the Most High God of Israel, the creator of heaven and earth, has commanded us to keep. But before we even get into the laws, you gotta know who you are. Okay? We're gonna show you your true nationality, you so-called Puerto Rican. And we're gonna base it first and foremost on the Bible, and we're gonna cross-reference it with historical facts that the scholars know, but they won't tell you. You go to the Smithsonian Museum, and there is many, many archaeological facts that the so-called Native American Indians, and the so-called Hispanics, and the so-called African Americans and Jamaicans are the children of Israel. But they had that hidden, and they will not get that out of the vault. But we're bringing out the truth, because we're commanded to do so today. Okay? John 8:32. All right? Because Christ himself said that the only way we will be free as a people is if we knew the truth. And we're gonna bring out the truth. That's what we do every single week, every single Saturday. We out here bringing out the truth to our people. We have jobs, we have businesses, we have wives, we have kids, we are professionals. We are not bums, we are not Muslims. We are here because we love our people, and we're here to show you who you are according to the Bible. All right?
Read the book of John, chapter 8, verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free, because y'all are under the illusion and you're free. We're in that captivity under so-called white man's reign. He calls it democracy. That's why y'all are asleep. Because democracy says that we're free and we all want people. We can choose what we want, okay? But that's not the case. What did Christ say?
And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
What is the truth? According to the Holy Bible, Psalm 119, 142. That's one part that the brother's gonna bring out. What's the other truth of the Bible? That you are the Israelites the Bible speaks of. You so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians of Indian and Negro descent. This is not about the color of your skin. It's about your true heritage, okay?
Read the book of Psalms, chapter 119, verse 142. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness.
Go ahead.
And thy law is the truth.
What is the truth?
Thy law is the truth.
The laws of the Most High God that we're commanded to follow are the truth. But y'all too rebellious to follow, but guess what? We are here for those that want to humble down and repent. Okay, so we're going to show you your true nationality, 2nd Ezra 13. Let's see and prove to you, according to the Holy Bible, that you so-called Hispanics and Native American Indians are the children of Israelites that the Bible speaks of. We're going to prove to you how it was that you got to this side of the world. Okay, because this side of the world was not inhabited by anyone until the 10 tribes of Israel came over here. Okay, we're going to prove it according to the Bible and historical facts. Read.
The book of 2nd Ezra, chapter 13, verse 40. Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king, whom Salmanesar, the king of Assyria, led away captive, and he carried them over the waters, and so came they into another land.
Into where?
Another land.
Go ahead.
But they took this counsel amongst themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen,
because they were amongst the other nations out of Assyria. Okay, go ahead.
And go forth into a further country.
In a further country, go ahead.
Where never mankind dwelt.
Read that again.
Where never mankind dwelt.
Go ahead.
That they might there keep their statutes, which they never kept in their own land.
Because we were not able to keep, kind of like today in America, that we don't know who we are, so we don't keep the laws. Okay? But we are here to show you what the laws are, so you can keep them. You're repenting Israelites. Go ahead.
And they entered into Euphrates.
Into the Euphrates.
By the narrow passages of the river.
Stop. Okay, so they entered into the Euphrates by the narrow passages of the river. Okay? So when you come up here, you see this area here. Okay, this is where Jerusalem and Israel is at, okay? They entered into the Euphrates, into the narrow passage of the river. Go ahead.
For the Most High then showed signs for them.
He showed signs. Why? Because the tribe of Issachar, who are the so-called Mexicans, they were blessed with the gift of being able to read the stars. So like modern day navigation, they have technology that helped them navigate. Back in the days, you used to use the stars to determine where you were going to go, okay? You were going to use the stars to navigate where was north, where was east, where was west, where was south, okay? So the Most High showed them signs through the stars. Go ahead.
For the Most High then showed signs for them, and hell stilled the flood.
Hell stilled the flood. What's the flood referring to? The Atlantic Ocean, the ocean. He hell stilled the flood so they could have a smooth ride and be able to get to this side of the land. Go ahead.
Till they were passed over.
So they were passed over. Go ahead.
For through that country,
go ahead,
there was a great way to go.
So there was a great way to travel through that country to get to this side of the world. Go ahead.
Namely, of a year and a half.
How long?
A year and a half.
So now you got to think about this. You got to put, let's put this in perspective with some visual aids. Okay? They came through the narrow passage of the Euphrates, all the way underneath the east coast of Africa, all the way underneath. Okay, this is the same map. All the way underneath, okay, until they started letting off the various tribes, okay, on this part of the world, okay? That took a year and a half. Go ahead.
And the same region is called Osiris.
What's the region called?
Osiris.
So now, in case you still don't believe, okay, we're going to prove to you, according to the scholars, a website called JewishEncyclopedia.com, which was not written by us, but by the so-called scholars, okay? So-called white man, to be exact. And they know the truth. So we're going to bring it out to you. Let's see what the definition of the word Osiris stands for, okay? Go ahead, brother.
This is from the Jewish Encyclopedia. Osiris, the name of the land beyond the great river, far away from the habitation of man, in which the 10 tribes of Israel will dwell.
Who will dwell there?
Israel.
Go ahead.
Observing the laws of Moses.
Of who?
Of Moses.
So far it's saying that the 10 tribes of Israel will dwell in this land called Osiris, observing the laws of Moses. Go ahead.
Until the time of the restoration.
Until the time, what's the restoration talking about? To the time that the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom come together as one nation. Because that is the mission that the Bible speaks of. What is our mission? To come out here and get you so-called blacks, Hispanics, Native American Indians together to learn this truth, to learn your true heritage, to follow the commandments according to thus saith the Lord, and to come together as it is prophesied in Ezekiel. Okay? To come together as one stick, as one nation. Go ahead.
According to 4th Ezra,
go ahead,
chapter 13, verse 45.
Where did we just read from?
The book of Ezra, chapter 2nd Ezra, chapter 13, verse 45.
Verse 45, the book, the chapter, and the verse. Go ahead.
Columbus identified America with this land.
Who identified?
Columbus identified America with this land.
Go ahead. That's it. So now, the scholars clearly know something that you so-called Hispanics don't know. Okay, Columbus knew that the Israelites were dwelling on this part of the world. The so-called Puerto Ricans, Cubans, Dominicans, so on and so forth. Okay, y'all make up the 10 tribes of Israel. So Columbus knew that. If you go online and you Google 1492, The Conquest of Paradise, which was a movie about Columbus, the first couple of minutes of the movie, he's sitting down talking with one of the Jesuit priests, okay? Which, by the way, Jesuit means is Latin for crafty ones, okay? So keep that in the back of your head. He was sitting down trying to justify why he wanted to come to this side of the earth. How do you know that there's people living there, okay? Because he said the book of Ezra, Prophet Ezra says that. That's what we just read from. Then he shows them the map, and the only thing that was on the map was the east part of the world. Everything else was black because this was a land where never mankind dwelt. But the only reason why Columbus knew is because he read the prophecies. He read the Bible. Okay? So this is why he knew that the 10 tribes were going to be here in America and that they were here. Okay? Is that it on that? Okay?
Yeah.
All right. Go ahead.
Is that in the technology?
Go ahead, read.
Then dwelt they there until the latter time, and now when they shall begin to come.
So it says the latter time. What's the latter time? What does latter mean? It means the last
before
day.
Before Christ returned, we were going to know that the so-called 10 tribes, so-called Hispanics, Native American Indians were going to be in America.
That is proof that it's not only the so-called blacks, West Indians, and Haitians that are Israelites, but it's also the so-called Hispanics and Native American Indians. Does that make sense, brother? Okay? This is all historical facts that we're bringing out. Okay? So now, that's it for that, right?
Right.
So now, let's prove it now that we are in captivity. Because a lot of you so-called Puerto Ricans don't believe that you're in captivity, that you're still in slavery. Yeah. Y'all don't believe that because you don't have physical chains or yokes of iron around your neck. Okay? But guess what? Make no mistake about it. Y'all did have that around your necks. In fact, the so-called Hispanics were the first ones that were brought into slavery before the so-called blacks. Okay? This is all proof right here. All you gotta do is read and research. See, that's the problem with a lot of your so-called Hispanics and blacks. Y'all don't read. And if you don't read, you're not gonna edify yourself. You're gonna depend on a so-called white man to educate you and tell you who you are. Okay? And that's the formula for destruction, because that's gonna keep you asleep. That was one of the main methods that they used to defeat the so-called blacks and Hispanics during slavery. They did not allow us to read. Why was that so prolific? Why was that such a most important thing for them? Because if you don't read, you can't see for yourself your historical facts, that who you truly are. This goes for the so-called blacks too, brother, but I'm focusing on the Hispanics right now, because they need to wake up. They're very hard-hitting. Okay, a lot of so-called Puerto Ricans, they think that they've arrived. Okay, because they got some light skin and some so-called good hair. Okay, but at the end of the day, man, we were all oppressed. Give me that, Jeremiah 50:33. We were all in slavery together. All of us, and the scripture's gonna prove it. Bring it out.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 50, verse 33. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel, and the children of Judah.
Children of Israel, which consists of the northern kingdom, and the children of Judah, which consists of the southern kingdom, on this chart right here, okay, go ahead.
Were oppressed together.
Were what?
Oppressed together.
Brother, what does the word oppressed mean? I can't hear you, brother. What's the word oppressed? If you're oppressed, what does it mean? I'm sorry? Now, oppressed is another word for slavery. Well, I'm not putting you on the spot, man. We're edifying you, okay?
I'm listening.
It's all good,
I'm learning.
It's all good. It means to be oppressed, to be held down, to be enslaved. Another word for slavery. What's it say?
We're oppressed together.
We're oppressed together, brother. Okay? We're oppressed together so much that we still live together. Look at the neighborhoods where we at. Okay? Our neighborhoods are full of blacks, Hispanics, okay, together. Projects. We all live together, yet we don't get along with each other. That's madness. We are the same people. We are brothers and sisters, according to the Bible. Okay? So now, let's prove that you so-called Puerto Ricans are still in captivity. You got something else? Okay, read that.
And all that took them captives held them fast. They refused to let them go.
Read that for the top again.
Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Judah were oppressed together.
We were in slavery together, go ahead.
And all that took them captives held them fast.
Why? Because we were in captivity. All the nations had us in captivity, brother. All the nations, starting with the so-called white man predominantly. But guess what? The Arabs had us in captivity. The Africans, okay, because the so-called blacks are not Africans, okay? They had us in captivity. Because remember, a brother don't sell a brother into captivity. Is that correct? And we're the same people. Why they sold us into captivity, okay? Go ahead.
And all that took them captives held them fast. They refused to let them go.
They refused to let us go, okay? Just like today, they refused to tell us that we are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. They refused because they know that once we come together as one nation, their reign is done, according to the Bible. Give me that in 2 Ezra 6, okay? Let me prove that to you, brother, that their reign is done, according to the Bible. Once we come together as one nation, once we get out of the niggerdom and out of the ignorance that we are in, and become one nation again. Go ahead.
The book of 2 Ezra, chapter 6, verse 54. And after these, Adam also, whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures.
What about you?
Sorry,
you
know
what I'm saying?
Oh, okay.
And what's on the soft one?
Go ahead.
2 Ezra, chapter 6, verse 9.
Listen closely, brother.
Start at 8.
Go ahead.
And he said unto me, from Abraham unto Isaac, when Jacob and Esau were born of him, Jacob's hand held first the heel of Esau.
Go ahead.
For Esau is the end of the world.
Esau is the biblical name of the so-called white man today. Just like our biblical name are the Israelites. Okay? And our biblical name comes from these tribes right here. Okay? Go ahead.
And Jacob is the beginning of it that followed.
Because this America is going to be destroyed by thermonuclear destruction. That's prophesied in the Bible. That's a done deal. Okay? It's just a matter of when. And when that happens, and the so-called white man is destroyed, and their doctrines, and their in America, okay, we're gonna rule, okay, once we come together. You follow what I'm saying, brother? Okay, that's prophecy, okay? So now, going back to the historical proof about your so-called Puerto Rican. This is a book called The Flame of Resistance. Okay, Puerto Rico, The Flame of Resistance. Listen to the words that are in the title. Resistance. Flame of Resistance. We're going to show you where, what they were resisting against.
Read. Puerto Rico, The Flame of Resistance. Tell the story of U.S. The U.S. history books leave out.
Tell the story of what?
Tells the story the U.S. history books leave out.
Okay, because you're not taught in school who you really are. You're not taught in school who your true nationality is. Go ahead.
Puerto Rico, The Flame of Resistance begins 500 years ago when Puerto Rico was the homeland of the Borinquen Indians.
The Borinquen Indians. Borinquen means brave. Okay, Boricua means brave. It's a Hebrew word that means brave. Borica means land of the brave lords, which is also a Hebrew word. But a lot of your so-called Puerto Ricans walk about, hey, Bori, yo soy Boricua. Y'all don't even know what it means. You don't even know that it's a Hebrew word. You think you're Spanish because supposedly you got light skin, or you say, I'm Spaniard. You a damn fool. Those Spaniards were the ones that enslaved you and killed your forefathers, okay? Because when you look at a map, where is Spain located? Spain is located in Europe, okay? I don't know if you can see it here. Okay, that's where Spain is located, okay? So if you're from Spain, guess what? You're European, you're a so-called white man, you're not an Israelite, okay? Go ahead.
Resistance to Spanish colonialism.
Spanish what?
Spanish colonialism.
Now when you look at what the word colonialism means, it means to come from the word to colonize, a colony. Okay, colonialism means that they came basically, I'm going to keep it very simple. They came to our land and they said, you know what? This is our land now. We're taking it. That's like somebody come to your house, you're sitting on your couch watching TV, and they come in and they say, yo, get out the house, man. It's my house now. How would that make you feel, brother? Not too good, right? Okay, go ahead.
Resistance to Spanish colonialism.
Spanish colonialism, go ahead.
Spark the flame that is burning today in Puerto Rican independence movement.
Now, question. Why would it be Spanish colonialism? Why are they talking about the Spanish and we're Spanish? First of all, when you look at the suffix ish, okay, that word means to be like, to be part of, okay? When you put that together with another word, the suffix and the prefix, an actual word, okay, it means to be like a Spaniard. So y'all so-called Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, Cubans are not Spanish, okay? The only reason why they say that is to keep you asleep. You are the Israelites the Bible speaks of. Go ahead.
In Puerto Rico, The Flame of Resistance, you read about the U.S. government seizure.
The U.S. what?
Government seizure.
Seizure, that means they took stuff from Puerto Rico. Go ahead.
Of the island as a colony.
As a colony. They took all our resources. They basically said, guess what? We're running stuff now. Okay, go ahead.
The monopolization of sugar by U.S. corporations.
Monopolization meaning they took over all of our resource, which was one of the resources, which was sugar. They monopolized it, meaning that they had full control over the sale of who buys it, who sells it, how much to put, the price to put on it. Go ahead.
And the more recent industrialization of the island.
Go ahead.
Alarming statistics about life in Puerto Rico under U.S. domination.
Under U.S. what?
Under U.S. domination.
You only when you're under domination, that means you're under control, brother. Does that make sense? Go ahead.
Such as 40% unemployed.
40% unemployed under the so-called white man's control. Go ahead.
And 35% of all women of childbearing age sterilized.
So all our sisters, 35% of them are sterilized, can't have children because of the so-called white man's inventions. Or going ahead and try to mess with the weather. Going ahead and try to clone animals. All that stuff, that's all part of his prophecy. Okay? Is that it there? Okay, read the bottom. Okay?
Puerto Rico, The Flame of Resistance. Tells the story the U.S. history books leave out.
The what?
The U.S. history books leave out.
So we ain't gonna get this story, brother. We are not gonna know who our true nation is. So you may be wondering, well, how come I never heard that in school that the so-called Hispanics and blacks are Israelites? That's the reason why. Because if it's in there, you gotta go ahead and wake up and be like, wait a minute, I ain't supposed to be at the bottom of the totem pole, okay? I'm a king, okay? I'm a prince, because that's what the word Israel means. The word Israel means prince of God. okay? We're kings and princes, all right? We're not supposed to be living in these environment that we're living in. But the so-called white man, by him keeping us down and not allowing us to read, okay, this is why we're in these conditions, okay? So now, we read 2 Ezra chapter 2, right? Read over here, then get ready.
There's an old Latin American legend about a foreign tyrant who tried to bury the truth.
Okay, so there's an old tyrant who tried to bury the truth.
This tyrant used arms to conquer another nation.
Okay, so right now this is talking about the Spaniards. Okay, go ahead.
He enslaved the people and forced them to work for his benefit.
This is what happened to you so-called Puerto Ricans and Hispanics. Right here. This is what the so-called Spaniard, who you love and claim to be Spanish, okay, which that in itself is a byword, all right, did to you. Go ahead.
The tyrant ordered the people to give up the truth.
All right, so the tyrant ordered the people to give up the truth. The truth of what? That we were the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. Go ahead.
He sent his soldiers into the land to gather the truth.
He sent his soldiers, the conquistadors, into the land to gather the truth of who we were as a people. Go ahead.
Some citizens refused to surrender what was rightfully theirs.
What was what?
What was rightfully theirs.
What was rightfully ours, because they came to the land of Puerto Rico and they destroyed it. They killed our mothers. They killed our fathers. They killed the children. In fact, there's accounts that when the babies were being born, they would take them out with umbilical cords and everything and smash them up against rocks. And that's prophecy in the Bible. Matter of fact, here you go right here, brother. That's a pictorial account of what the so-called Spaniards, who the Puerto Ricans think they are, okay, did to our people. Go ahead.
Some citizens refused to surrender what was rightfully theirs.
That's just common sense. If you somebody come to your house, you're going to fight for that. Somebody trying to take your apartment, right, brother? Okay, go ahead.
And they were shot or jailed.
And they were what?
Shot or jailed.
Deuteronomy 28:49. Let's see and prove that that was prophecy that the book is talking about.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 49. The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far, from the end of the earth, as swift as the eagle flight.
What nation is that talking about? We were already here, if you look at the map, we were already at this part of the world. Okay, the scripture said what? Start from the top.
The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far.
Nation from far, from the other side of the world, go ahead.
From the end of the earth.
End of the earth, go ahead.
As swift as the eagle flight.
Now why did he use the word eagle? Okay, because when you look at history, okay, the eagle, all the nations that have ruled over us, all the great nations, what has been their symbol throughout history? The eagle, okay? You have Greeks, their symbol was the eagle. We were under their captivity. You have the Romans, their symbol was the eagle. We were under their captivity. The Spanish, their symbol was the eagle. We were under their captivity. And last but definitely not least, America's symbol is the eagle. And we are under their captivity. Whether you believe it or not, you so-called blacks and Hispanics. Okay, because we are not free in America. Okay, go ahead.
A nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand.
Why did it say a nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand? Because we didn't speak Spanish. We spoke Hebrew. And the fact of that is, you read the book by Tolomé de las Casas, they will go ahead and read orders to us at night, middle of the night, while we were sleeping, in Spanish, talking about that if we don't surrender that part of the land, they were going to go in and destroy us. How are we going to understand those orders if we didn't speak Spanish? Number one. Number two, why is it that Columbus, through historical facts, brought Hebrew translators with him to this side of the world? Because he knew that we spoke Hebrew and that we were the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. Okay, go ahead.
A nation of fierce countenance.
Right, fierce countenance, because they came. Look at the pictures right here, how they came. Okay, they came with fierce anger. Okay? They came to destroy us as a people. Go ahead.
Which shall not regard the person of the old.
They didn't care if you were old timer. They know how you're supposed to have respect for your elders. They didn't care about that.
Nor show favors to the young.
They didn't care how young you were. They were still going to do you in. You were still going to get killed. Go ahead.
Hey.
That's it from there?
That's it.
Okay. Where'd you stop that?
Stopped over here.
51? Okay. All right. Give me 41.
Verse 41. Thou shalt beget sons and daughters.
Okay, go ahead.
But thou shalt not enjoy them.
Why were we not going to enjoy them?
For they shall go
into captivity.
You understand what captivity means, right, brother? You already spoke that. It all falls under oppression. It all falls under slavery. It's the same thing. They took our children from us. The same exact way that they did to the so-called blacks, that's the same way they did to us. Okay? Columbus, the so-called white man, okay, who was commissioned by Spain, okay, and came with the Spaniards, the conquistadors, who you so-called simple Puerto Ricans think you are. Okay? We're here to wake you guys up. But that's the only way you're gonna get salvation.
That's right.
But we only want those people. Scripture says already that only 1/3 of our people are gonna be saved. So we want those humble spirits, okay, to recognize who you are according to the Bible, to repent. Okay? Go ahead, go back to that second chapter you were reading.
The tyrant ordered the people to give up the truth.
Okay, go ahead.
He sent his soldiers into the land to gather the truth.
Go ahead.
Some citizens refused to surrender what was rightfully theirs.
Go ahead.
And they were shot.
They were what?
Shot.
Go ahead.
Or jailed.
Read. Let's see if that was prophecy in the Bible.
Verse 31, Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 31.
Yep.
Thine ox shall be slain before thine eyes, and thou shalt not eat thereof.
Go ahead.
Thine ass shall be violently taken away.
Shall be what?
Violently taken away.
Go ahead.
From before thy face.
Go ahead.
And shall not be restored to thee.
We were never going to get it back, and we never got it back. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Thy sheep shall be given unto thine enemies.
Go ahead. Yeah.
The fruit of thy land and all thy labors shall a nation.
So we built up, when history proves that when Columbus got to this part of the world, that America, we were civilized. We had cities, okay? We were not like they like to depict us in underwear or cloths around us, okay? Savages. Because when you look at the word Indian means slave or savage. It's a Latin word. That's what they described us as, okay? We were not like that. Historical facts prove that we had buildings, okay, made out of pyramids. All right, why did we have pyramids? Because we're the ones who built the pyramids in Egypt. We knew how to build those, okay? We built civilizations, okay? We had riches, we had trade, okay? And the so-called white man, the Spaniards, took all of that away from us. Go ahead.
Shall the fruit of thy land and all thy labors shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up, and thou shalt be only oppressed and crushed always.
It goes that word again. We shall be always oppressed, okay, enslaved and crushed always. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So now, so far you see the curses that were put upon us that the so-called white man did to us. Okay. While we were in slavery. Okay. Now let's prove to you further that the so-called Puerto Ricans are in the Bible. Okay. Under the word, the name Joseph. Okay. Because Joseph was the forefather of Ephraim and Manasseh. Ephraim is the tribe of Puerto Rico. Ephraim is the so-called Puerto Ricans, and Manasseh are the so-called Cubans. Let's prove that.
The book of Genesis, chapter 49, verse 22. Joseph is a fruitful bough.
It says Joseph is a fruitful bough. The word fruitful means plentiful, abundance, okay? The word bough is another word for a tree. Historically, the symbol of all the tribes have a symbol, okay? Like, for example, the so-called blacks, the tribe of Judah, they had the lion as their symbol. Our symbol is the tree, according to the Bible. But it's a fruitful tree. It's not just no damn, you know, a weak tree. It's a strong, powerful tree. So it says what?
Joseph is a fruitful bough.
Go ahead.
Even a fruitful bough by a well.
Why does it use the word by a well? Where's Puerto Rico located? It's surrounded by water, okay? So it's a fruitful bough, a fruitful land located around water by a well. Okay, go ahead.
And branches run over the wall.
Why does it say the branches run over the water? Branches represents our daughters. Why? Because when the conquistadors came to our part of the land, over here, America, Puerto Rico, the Caribbean, North Central, South America, our daughters, they raped our daughters, and our daughters, like today, and a lot of our women, they like to go with the so-called white man, okay? They did it back then too, okay? So that's why it says they went over the wall. The wall signifies there's a fort in Puerto Rico called El Morro. That's the wall that it's talking about. They went over the wall. It's all a metaphor or a similitude to show that our sisters, they went off and started mingling with the other nation. And that is forbidden in the Bible, okay? We are not supposed to mix with the other nation, in particular the so-called white people. Go ahead. Did I see that? Okay, go ahead, read.
The box one, right?
Yep, the box one.
Wait, sorry.
Oh, wait, he got more. Listen up.
The archers have sorely grieved him.
The archers what?
Have sorely grieved him.
You know what an archer is, brother? You ever heard of archery? What does archery consist of? Bow and arrow, right? Right, you're shooting at the target. So it's using here, the metaphor word it's using is the archers. They didn't come with bow and arrow. We had the bow and arrow. They came with muskets, with cannons, okay? That's not what they came with to destroy us. Go ahead.
And shot at him.
And shot at him. What did it say in the book?
The part about the shot?
Yep.
Some citizens refused to surrender what was rightfully theirs, and they were shot.
And they were shot.
And they were shot or jailed.
Or jailed. Go ahead, read.
And shot at him and hated him.
Go ahead.
But his bow abode in strength.
Okay, but our bow, the so-called, the 10 tribes, the so-called Puerto Ricans, okay, our bow was bowed in strength. So the Most High gave us enough strength. Go ahead.
And the arms of his hands were made strong. The
arms of our hands were made strong. He gave us enough strength so that 10 tribes, so-called Puerto Ricans, would not be extinct. Okay, so they will not be fully exterminated. He gave us enough so we could fight them all. Okay, but so that we could still know that, damn, we messed up for not following the laws. Go ahead.
By the hands of the mighty God of Jacob, from thence is the shepherd, the stone of Israel.
What's the shepherd, the stone of Israel? That's talking about Christ.
He could see that on the exact spot where he had buried the truth, there was.
Why did you say bury the truth? Again, you got to understand that this is a metaphor, okay? You got to look at it spiritual, okay? He buried the truth. What truth did he bury? By killing, trying to kill all of us off, the truth that we were the children of God. The truth that we were the Israelites. That's what he tried to bury. But what happened?
From a distance, he could see that on the exact spot where he had buried the truth, there was a strong and beautiful tree.
A strong and beautiful what?
Beautiful tree.
Give me 49 again.
Joseph is a fruitful bow.
Fruitful bow, a tree. Read, tree.
Moreover, there was a crowd of peasants with machetes.
So he saw from far away that even though he tried to go ahead and exterminate us, we were still coming hard. Because that was prophecy that was going to happen. The Most High was going to give us that power. Go ahead.
Moreover, there was a crowd of peasants with machetes, shovels, and hoes.
The peasants are supposed to be us. This is what they call it, because in their eyes, we were peasants. The Spaniards' eyes. Go ahead.
The tyrant's heart pounded against his chest.
The tyrant's heart pounded against his chest. Okay, go ahead.
He was afraid.
He was afraid. Go ahead.
Even as he walked toward the tree, it grew taller and taller.
Give me Revelation 11:11. Okay, it said that the tyrant was afraid, brother. Okay, when he saw that we were not laying down. Okay, that's prophesied in the Bible, because that's what's happening now, right in front of everybody's eyes. Go ahead.
The book of Revelation, chapter 11, verse 11.
Go ahead.
After 3 days and a half.
350 years of captivity, we were going to wake up. Go ahead.
The spirit of life from God.
The spirit of life, meaning the Bible, the laws, the truth, the commandments. Go ahead.
Entered into them.
Enter into the tribes of Israel, all 12 tribes. Go ahead.
And they stood upon their feet.
And we stood upon our feet. Go ahead.
And great fear fell upon them and which saw them.
And great fear what?
Fell upon them which saw them.
Read that.
Moreover, the tyrant's heart pounded against his chest.
Great fear.
He was afraid.
He was afraid. Great fear.
Even as he walked toward the tree, it grew taller and taller.
Taller and taller. Read.
And they stood upon their feet, and great fear fell upon them which saw them.
Okay, the other nations are fearing right now that this truth is coming out. That we are waking up our people, because they know we are in the last days. No one knows when Christ is going to return, according to Matthew 24:36. But guess what? Look at the signs that are happening around. Bombings, explosions, hurricanes, earthquakes, rumors of wars and wars. Go ahead.
11:11, finish. Yes.
Okay. All right, so that's the fear that's talking about. Go ahead.
The peasants raised their tools and let out a cry.
Go ahead.
The tyrant could see that the roots of the tree went deep.
That our roots went deep. So no matter how much they try to destroy us, the truth was never going to be hit for long. It was not going to be hit for long because our history goes too deep. A lot of brothers like to say, oh, Egypt, the Egyptians were the oldest race. No, you weren't. The Israelites were first. And that's we were right. Only chosen from the Most High God. Go ahead.
The tyrant could see that the roots of the tree went deep into the rich earth.
Read.
The trunk of the tree was too wide.
The trunk of the tree was too wide, too massive. Go ahead.
To put his arms around.
He couldn't even put his arms around it. Go ahead.
And his branches were long and powerful.
Well, branches talking about the other tribes were long and powerful. Go ahead, bring it out, brother.
The book of Psalms, chapter 1, verse 3.
Go ahead.
And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water.
That's beautiful right there. Read that again from the top.
And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water.
Who's that he, the Israelites? Go ahead.
That bringeth forth his fruit in his season.
Oh,
his
praise.
Leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper.
Read that part again.
The tyrant could see that the roots of the tree went deep into the rich earth. The trunk of the tree was too wide to put his arms around.
We just read that in the Bible.
And his branches were long and powerful.
Go ahead, is that it for that box?
Yep.
Okay, what we got here? Okay, read the bottom, next one.
There were millions of budding branches, each one distinct, and yet they were one and the same.
Read that from the beginning again and slow.
There were millions of budding branches, each one distinct, and yet they were one and the same.
It says there was millions of budding branches, each one distinct, yet one and the same. Why is that significant? Because a lot of y'all so-called Hispanics think, because, oh, I'm light-skinned. All right, so I'm not part of them. Nah, I'm not with them so-called blacks. Okay, I can't be an Israelite. But what did it say?
There were millions of budding branches, each one distinct, and yet they were one and the same.
Because we're innumerable according to the scriptures. Okay? According to the scriptures, you can't count us. Even though they try to do a census every 10 years. Okay? And if you notice, they only do it in our neighborhoods. That's to number us, to see how strong we are in numbers. Okay? But they can't number us because this prophecy said they can't. We are an innumerable number. Okay? Go ahead. Is that it on that?
Yep.
Okay? Right. So now, they said we were a billion branches, distinct, yet the same. Let's prove in the Bible that that's talking about the Israelites.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 12 and verse 9. My heritage is unto me as a speckled bird.
So Jeremiah is speaking in the spirit of the Lord. He says that his heritage, the Lord's heritage, is the children of Israel, are the Israelites. Go ahead.
My heritage is unto me as a speckled bird.
As a speckled bird. Now, what is significant about a speckled bird? The characteristics of a speckled bird. When you go online, you Google speckled bird, it's the same bird, but they're all different colors. Okay? They're all different shapes, some of them, but it's still the same species. So you need to go ahead and get that foolishness out your mind. Well, I'm light-skinned, so that don't mean me. Okay? Guess what? The scripture says, my heritage is unto me as a speckled bird.
That's right.
Okay? Go ahead.
My heritage is unto me as a speckled bird. The birds round about are against her. Come ye, assemble all the beasts of the field. Come to devour.
Okay? Come to devour. So now read.
For hundreds of years, foreign tyrants have dominated Puerto Rico. They have used every means possible to try and bury the truth about Puerto Rico.
The truth about Puerto Rico, that we are the Israelites. Now you so-called Puerto Ricans are from the tribe of Ephraim. Now you so-called Dominicans, Cubans, Native American Indians, you so-called blacks, Jamaicans, Haitians, all the children of Israel according to the Bible and historical facts proven.
That's right. They have tried to bury the truth that Puerto Rico was and still is today an oppressed nation.
A what nation?
An oppressed nation.
No, the hell no, man. Your Puerto Ricans are free.
That Puerto Rico was and still is today an oppressed nation.
Y'all so-called Puerto Ricans better wake up. All right, y'all the children of Israel, the Bible speaks of. Y'all are still in slavery, okay, according to the Holy Scriptures.
That's right.
Okay, so y'all make no mistake about it. Y'all walk around with the Puerto Rican flag, don't even know that the so-called white man forced that flag on you.
That's right.
You don't know your history. That's not the way your flag look. Okay, your flag is supposed to have a fruitful tree on it, according to the Bible. That's your ensign. That's your banner. And you out here every year acting like fools and coons on a Puerto Rican Day parade, raping your own women, robbing your own people, celebrating something that you're not, because you're not Puerto Rican. You're an Israelite from the tribe of Ephraim, according to the Bible.
They have tried to bury the truth that Puerto Rico was and still is today an oppressed nation.
Go ahead.
A colony, a land imprisoned by foreign tyrants.
By who?
Foreign tyrants.
Y'all don't even know Puerto Rico anymore. Y'all so-called Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, Cuban, y'all don't even know that anymore. Okay? Y'all don't even own your own land that was given to you by the Most High God. That's historical facts. Go ahead.
Is that it for the box?
Okay, go ahead.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 33.
And here's the proof in the Bible, the one and only true book. Go ahead.
The fruit of thy land and all thy labors shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up.
Eat up, go ahead.
And thou shalt be only oppressed and crushed always.
Isn't that the word it used in the book?
It says right here that Puerto Rico was and still is today an oppressed nation.
And thou shalt be only oppressed and crushed always.
Go ahead.
Verse 29. And thou shalt grope at noonday as the blind gropeth in darkness.
Why does it use that metaphor? That you're going to grope at noonday. Okay, as the blind. A blind man, if they can't see, they're groping. They're trying to reach for stuff to get to their destination. It says we're going to grope. One of the curses is going to be we were going to grope at noonday. Why noonday? That's the brightest time of the day. We should be able to see everything. But because we're asleep under the so-called white man, America's doctrine and philosophy, we are asleep and we grope like a blind man. But we are here to change that. For those so-called blacks and Hispanics that want to repent, we're here to show you who you are and show you the laws and the process that you need to go ahead and take, okay, to repent. Go ahead.
And thou shalt grope at noonday as the blind gropeth in darkness.
Go ahead.
And thou shalt not prosper in thy
ways. It says we ain't going to prosper in our ways. See, some of us may have businesses and some of us may have good jobs. A lot of us have good jobs up here, okay, white collar jobs, blue collar jobs, okay, but we still ain't prospering as a nation. As a nation. Forget about as Americans. As a nation. The nation of Israel. Go ahead.
And thou shalt only be oppressed and spoiled evermore.
The word spoiled. When something spoiled, that means it's no good. So right now, as a nation, we're no good, according to the Most High. Go ahead.
And no man shall save me.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Go ahead. Read.
From the late 15th to late 19th century, Puerto Rico was a colony of the Spanish Empire. The land, labor, and resources were controlled by Spain.
By who?
By Spain.
No, by the Puerto Ricans own everything in Puerto Rico.
The land, labor, and resources were controlled by Spain.
You ain't got no control over your own island anymore. Go ahead.
Since 1898, Puerto Rico has been the direct colony of the U.S.
It's been a colony, meaning it was colonized, meaning in plain street terms, you got robbed. That's what that means. Your land was taken. The so-called white man is very crafty. They just use the word colony, okay, to make it seem like, oh, you know, it's just something that we had to do to make a better life for ourselves. We just came by, you know, we made a deal with the so-called Israelite men and women, and we said, you know what, you give us this, we'll give you that. No, that's not how they do it, because we just went over how they did it by force. Go ahead.
U.S. corporations have exploited the wealth of the island.
But wait a minute. It's not just the Spanish, right? Who else?
U.S. corporations have exploited the wealth of the island and the labor of the Puerto Rican people.
That's a very important word, the word exploited. When you look at the dictionary, the word exploited means that it was taken unfairly. Okay? You were exposed. It was taken from you. Okay? Is that it on that? Go ahead.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 31. Thine ox shall be slain before thine eyes.
Okay, our own flocks, our own livestock was taken. Okay, go ahead.
And thou shalt not eat thereof. Thine ass shall be violently taken away from before thy face, and shall not be restored to thee. Thy sheep shall be given unto thine enemies, and thou shalt have none to rescue them.
Okay, that's it on that? Okay, go ahead, read.
The Taino Indians.
The
Taino Indians, the native people, called the island Borinque.
Where you from? All right, you consider yourself Puerto Rican? Okay. You know what the word Taino means?
I don't believe in nationality. I believe we're all equal.
We're all equal. I just read all this stuff to you. You still gonna believe we're all equal? I just read to you that the Spanish and the U.S. colonies went to your land, brother, and took all your resources, killed your mother, your father, your cousin, your brother, and you still believe we're all equal? Read that, brother. Read that. We're not out.
We're all equal, man. We're all human beings, man.
The book of 2nd Exodus, chapter 6, verse 54. And after these, Adam also, whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures, of him come we all.
Listen closely, because you said we all equal. Let's see what the Most High God says in the Bible. Go ahead.
And the people also whom thou hast chosen.
Go ahead.
All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sake.
He made the world for the Israelites, the so-called blacks and Spanish and Puerto Ricans. Okay, so that's strike one, that there's no such thing as equality with the Most High. Go ahead.
As for the other people.
As for who?
The other people.
The other nations who you say we are equal with.
Which also come of Adam.
Which thou, because we all come from Adam, right? But there's a stipulation. Go ahead.
Thou hast said that they are nothing.
No, there's equality with the Most High.
They are nothing.
Go ahead.
But be like unto spittle.
Spittle, you know what spittle is, brother? You know when you spit, the little stuff that comes out, that's how below the other nations are. Okay? Uh-huh.
And has likened the abundance of them unto a drop that falleth from a vessel.
Brother, if I got a bucket of water, un jardín de agua, ¿verdad? Y estoy caminando, and a drop falls out. Am I gonna care if a drop falls out of that bucket of water? Am I gonna care? Am I gonna care? Because I got a full bucket of water, right? The Most High is calling the other nations that little drop that is insignificant. Go ahead. You see what I mean? Go ahead.
And now, O Lord, behold, these heathen, which have ever been reputed as nothing.
Heathen means the other nations. Reputed means they are less than nothing. Go ahead.
Have begun to be lords over us.
They're lords over us right now. They so much lords over us that they got you believing that we're equal. That's how much they're controlling your mind, brother. That's why you gotta wake up. That's why we out here to tell our people the truth. Okay, now you so-called Puerto Ricans, you are the tribe of Ephraim. Okay, I just read historical facts from the Bible and the scholars. Not only that, this is historical facts right here, that the Spaniards did this to our people. Did they not, brother, do this to our people? Okay, and who was the one that did this to our people? The so-called hero that our people like to go ahead and march in their Salsa and Merengue on Columbus Day. You're honoring a killer that killed our people.
Raped our women.
Wait a minute, brother, but we equal, right? Last time I checked, if we equal, you don't kill each other, right, brother? And they destroyed it. So much so that you even believe that that we're equal. Now, brother, guess what? You know why I'm getting on you? Because you don't know, okay? We're here out of love, brother, okay? I want you to understand that. We speak loud because the Bible commands us to speak loud like a trumpet, so our people can hear. Get that, okay? So don't take it wrong. You know, we're men, bro, right? A man speaks out of eye, and we speak like this, right? Especially us Latinos, correct? We're very animated, correct? Okay? Because guess what? We're angry, man, because we were lied to since kids. Our parents were lied to. You understand what I'm saying? That we were Puerto Rican. You know what Puerto Rico means, brother? What's the interpretation of Puerto Rico?
Puerto Rico.
Rich boy, right? Rich boy. That's the thing, is it not? Yes. How can we be a thing? We are human beings, like he said. He said we're human beings. Then why do they call us a thing? Think about that, brother. Think about it. You can't be a Puerto Rich boy. Can I put a boat on your back and dock it? No, because you're not a port. It may sound simple and corny, but guess what? Sometimes we got to speak to our people like that sometimes. We don't realize that we are special people according to the Bible. Okay? We're special people according to the Bible. We ain't got time for games, man. Those who want to hear, you come up here and you learn your true nationality. You learn the steps to repentance. That's the only thing that's going to get you saved. But just knowing that you're an Israelite man or woman ain't going to save you, brother. You got to know the laws. Okay? You got to know the laws, but that's the steps to repentance. First, you got to bethink, you'll get that from you. Okay? First, you got to remember who you are. Well, let's see what the steps to repentance are. Okay? Once you realize, based on all these historical facts, okay, show them the book. So you can see we're coming out of a book that's not the Bible. But y'all people who don't believe the Bible, guess what? Historical facts prove that the Bible is a true book.
I believe the Bible.
Okay, so if you believe the Bible, brother, you got to believe that you're an Israelite man. Okay, and you got to start taking the steps to repentance. Okay? One of the first things you got to do is stop the smoking.
The flame of resistance.
Okay? Hey, read that. Let me show you the steps, brother. Let me show you. What's your name, brother? Tony, what's your name, sir?
Elliot.
Elliot and Tony. Listen up.
The book of 1 Kings, chapter 8, and verse 46. If they sin against thee, for there is no man that sinneth not.
Because we all sin. We all sin. Okay, Paul said he died daily. Okay, meaning he sinned daily. But guess what? It's picking yourself up. And I'm not talking about that you could go ahead and be a homosexual. You could be a drug addict. You could be an adulterer. And it's okay because you got grace. That's Christianity. That's nonsense. That's not what this Bible teaches. Okay? This Bible teaches that you break the law, you better repent from that and not do it again. That's what repentance is. Go ahead.
If they sin against thee, for there is no man that sinneth not.
Go ahead.
And thou be angry with them.
Go ahead.
And deliver them to the enemy.
We deliver them to the enemy because all these historical facts, all the slavery that we were in, all the torture that the Spaniards did to us, the Lord put them to do that to us. Why? Because we repent, we rebel against the laws of the Most High. Go ahead.
So that they carry them away captives.
After you're captives?
Captives. Unto the land of the enemy.
Unto the land of the enemy. Right now, we're in the land of the enemy. Because we don't own this. Okay? Y'all say you're Americans? Guess what, man? That's a foolish statement to make. You're Americans under their philosophy, but not under the Most High, who rules everything.
Right? Unto the land of the enemy, far or near. Yet, if they shall bethink themselves.
Bethink themselves means if you remember who you are, what your true nationality is, go ahead.
In the land whither they were carried captives, and repent.
And repent, go ahead.
And make supplication unto thee.
Make supplication, go ahead.
Unto thee in the land of them that carried them captives.
So wherever we are captives, whether we are slaves, we're supposed to repent and ask for forgiveness.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Saying, we have sinned and have done perversely. We have committed wickedness.
Okay, so that's what you got to say, buddy. You hear that, Tony? What we got to say? You hear that, Elliot? What we got to say? Now I want you to understand something. You took a picture of this book, which is great.
Sorry.
You can find it on Amazon, but guess what? A brand new copy of that book is how much it goes for.
Say it again.
$400, brother. Okay, why? Because they don't want us to have it. Exactly. You think, see, brother, now you are point. Nothing. You see, you know, your spirit is telling you what the Bible is bringing out.
What, say that again, I didn't
okay?
hear that.
This book, I was explaining to Elliot, okay? You can find it on Amazon. Guess how much a brand new copy of that book is? $400 at the least. Okay? You gotta ask yourself, why is that the case? Elliot brought out the answer. Okay, they don't want us to know. Because we'll be quick to spend $200 on a pair of Air Jordans to make the other nations rich. Because we don't make that. But we're not going to go ahead and pay double that to find out who we are. Because guess what? Whether you believe it or not, when you die, if you don't die as an Israelite man or woman, you're not getting salvation. Okay? You're not going to get salvation. Everything that I brought out here, I encourage every single one of y'all here to do your own research. Don't just take my word for it. Okay? Read the Bible yourself. That was all prophecy in the Bible. We are the children of Israel. We are the Israelites. Okay? Do not buy the so-called white man's theory that we walked over the Bering Straits, which was full of ice, freezing, okay, which is very far to go from ocean to ocean, and we got here to this land. From Asia, at that. That's not how it went down. Give me 2nd Exodus 13, because you weren't here, Elliot. You weren't here. Let's see how the so-called Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, Cubans, Native American Indians got over here. Listen to the Bible. Listen up good.
The book of 2nd Exodus, chapter 13, verse 40. Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king, whom Salmanesar, the king of Assyria, led away captive. And he carried them over the waters, and so came they into another land.
Hold on. It said that we were taken out of our own land. That land is Jerusalem. When you read Galatians 4:26, Jerusalem is our home. Okay? And we were taken away captives by the Assyrians. Go ahead.
But they took...
To where? To another land?
Into another land.
Go ahead.
But they took this counsel amongst themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go forth into a further country.
Okay, so they wanted to go ahead and follow the commandments, follow the Lord, but they couldn't do it based on the captivity under the Assyrians. That's why they call it the heathen. Okay, go ahead.
And of the heathen, and go forth into a further country where mankind never dwelt.
That's very key. Read that again.
Where never mankind dwelt.
So they went left and went to a country where never mankind dwelt. You gotta understand something. All life started on the east of the world. This land here, nobody lived here. The Most High God prepared that for us, as you're going to see in the scriptures, for the prophecy to be fulfilled. But nobody lived on this part of the land. All life forms started here. Yes, including the Puerto Ricans. Okay, but we're not Puerto Rican. We started here. Okay.
That they might there keep their statutes, which they never kept in their own land.
Okay.
And they entered into Euphrates.
All right, so now let's look at this. They were here, this is where Jerusalem is. Okay, remember, they were taken away out of the land. So they entered into the Euphrates River. Okay, go ahead.
By the narrow passages of the river.
By the narrow passages of the river, because Euphrates is wide, it's narrow compared to the ocean. Go ahead.
For the Most High then showed signs for them.
What signs did he show? How did sailors navigate years ago before technology? Stars, right? Okay, those are the signs that he showed. The tribe of Issachar, which are the so-called Mexicans, in the Bible it says their gift was that they were able to read the stars. Not for wickedness like astrology and all that stuff, but for navigation purposes, right? So he said the Most High held still the show signs, go ahead.
And held still the flood.
Held through the flood. The flood is referring to the ocean. He kept it calm so that their journey could be smooth. Okay, go ahead. There you go.
Till they were passed over.
So they were passed over. Go ahead.
For through that country.
All right, so through that country. Go ahead.
There was a great way to go.
Great way to go. So follow my finger. The Tigris, Euphrates. They came out here to the Indian Ocean. Okay, follow all the east coast of Africa. Go ahead.
Namely, of a year and a half.
Of a year and a half. Same picture, Africa. Came all the way over here and started letting the tribes off. Now they went off. Okay? This is a historical fact. On ships, because yes, we had ships. We didn't have any ships. Okay, go ahead.
And the same region is called Arsarat.
Now here's the kicker right here. How is the final proof that this is talking about America here, this the North Central South America? What does it say?
And the same region is called Arsarat.
That's proof that Arsarat is talking about this side of the world and that you so-called Hispanics, okay, are the Israelites. So-called blacks and Jamaicans also, but I'm focusing on Hispanics.
Trinidad,
okay, all right. This is from a website called JewishEncyclopedia.com. You may want to write that down to do every research. Okay, this is not our words. Let's show them. This is a printout from JewishEncyclopedia.com, what the brother here is going to read right now. Okay, go ahead. This is the definition of the word Arsarat that the Bible used and that the scriptures used. Go ahead.
JewishEncyclopedia.com. Stay, hold on, don't leave here. This is important. Arsarat, the name of the land beyond the great river.
The great river, the Atlantic Ocean. Go ahead.
Far away from the habitation of man.
Far away from the habitation of man. Why? Because this part of the earth wasn't inhabited. But this part was, so it was far away from the part that was inhabited. Go ahead.
In which the 10 tribes.
Who?
The 10 tribes.
We just read that 10 tribes. Go ahead.
Of Israel will dwell.
Will dwell. Go ahead. 10 tribes.
Observing the laws of Moses.
Why? Didn't they just say that they left because they wanted to observe the laws? Right? Go ahead.
Until the time of the restoration.
What's the restoration mean? When we all come together as one nation. But make no mistake about it. So-called black, as much as the Hispanics, light-skinned ones especially, and even within our own people. If you dark, you don't like the dark skins, don't like the light skins. For whatever stupid reason. Okay? But we were all in slavery together. In fact, the Hispanics were the first ones in slavery. Okay? 1492, so-called blacks didn't go into slavery until about 1619. Okay, but we're still brothers and sisters, we're still one nation. Okay, not the so-called white man, not the so-called Chinese, not the so-called Arab, not the so-called Africans. Okay, they are not Israel. Hold your thought, brother. Hold your thought. I'm gonna handle the question. All right, we all one nation. So that restoration is talking about us coming together, hearing this truth, learning who we are as a people according to the Bible, and start following the commandments. All combination. You can't have one without the other. Okay? Go ahead. Go ahead.
According to 4th Ezra chapter 13, verse 45.
We just read that. Go ahead.
Columbus identified America with this land.
With the land of Arsarat. With the land of Arsarat. That's it there? With the land of Arsarat. Is there any doubt? That's in the Apocrypha. He read the Apocrypha. You go online. You go ahead, go to YouTube, Google 1492, the conquest of paradise.
Yeah.
Right, the Apocrypha is part of the Bible.
Right.
Okay, remember, there was 80 books originally in the Bible. The Apocrypha was taken out in 1769 by the Protestants. The word Protestant comes from the word protest. They protested the Apocrypha because they said, if that stays in the Bible, we're done. Because the truth is going to be brought out. That's the whole point behind the Apocrypha being taken out. And that's why there's only 66 books now. But there was always 80. Go ahead, brother, speak.
What he's talking about, like this version here, this Bible here, this is called the 1611 version. I'm going to find this in Barnes & Noble. All right? This is the original, not the first Bible they made, but the way they put it together, this is how it was.
How would I know? Because I know there's different systems. Like, how would I know? I got the.
No, that's it.
King James 1611.
King James 1611 Bible.
You can't get 1611, but it has the Apocrypha.
The Apocrypha is already in it because the original Bible, when it was put together, all the books, this is how it was. And like your brother brought out, it was taken out.
But understand something. All of that, that's semantics.
Like the Pope.
What you need to know is that you're an Israelite man. You said you're Trinidadian? Okay. That means you're from the tribe of Benjamin. Okay? From the tribe of Benjamin. From the southern. You need to know that. And after that, you need to know what the laws are. Okay, follow the command. All that semantics of, you know what? I need to speak Hebrew. The J, the Y, the A, A-E-I-O-U, and all that nonsense, that's ridiculous. And that's not going to get you salvation. And we don't deal with none of that nonsense. You know what? You deal with your laws. You know what I'm saying? So, as you see, the word Ozarin, Columbus even knew. So like I was saying, you Google and YouTube, the 1492, the Conquest of Paradise. In the first few minutes of the movie, it has Columbus petitioning to go to this side of the earth. And he's speaking with a Jesuit priest, which as I mentioned earlier, the word Jesuit is Latin for crafty ones. Okay? So crafty ones, crafty, meaning they're full of life. They're slick. Immaculate Conception Church, Catholic religion, right? Those are Jesuits, okay? Just keep that in the back of your mind. So in there he says, he's talking how he wants to take that journey to this part of the world. So the Jesuit priest goes, that's crazy, you know. How do you know there's even any life there? He goes, the prophet Ezra said. He says, Ezra's a Jew, okay? He goes, he's a madman. He's trying to discourage him from finding out the truth, number one. Number two, there's a book called Lost Tribes in Promised Land. In there, Columbus brought Hebrew translators with him when they came over here. Why?
I read that.
Why? Why would he bring Hebrew translators if we spoke Spanish? Because a lot of like to think that we, the Spanish is our language. First of all, when you look, it came from Spain. It was forced on us. Just like America was, American was forced on us. English was forced on us. Okay? We're not from Britain. And we're not from Spain, whether you believe it or not. Okay? Whether you believe it or not, that's historical fact. Okay? In fact, the word Boricua, you know what, where are you from, brother? What's your nationality? Puerto Rico, Cuba?
Yeah, Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico, okay.
Puerto Rico.
What's the word Boricua mean?
Just a Hebrew word. I
really don't know, man.
Y'all don't know what it is? Give it a shot. But a lot of us call that Bori, right? Oye, Bori. Oye, Bori. Yo soy Boricua, real proud, right? And you don't even know what it is. Guess why it's a Hebrew word that means brave. Hey, we are brave. Bravo, brave. It's a Hebrew word that means brave. What does Boricua mean? Because that was really the name of the island, right? Okay, Boricua. It means land of the brave lords.
They made a project named Boricua.
Okay, group, land of the brave lords is what Boricua means. Okay? So we are brave, strong people. But why don't we act like that now? Why don't we act like that now? Why don't we wake up? Why do we want to continue to fall into the doctrines of America?
You act like that.
Okay? Listen, the Bible said we got to follow the government. There's no doubt about it. We're not talking about go out there and start getting crazy. Now, we all follow the law. But that law was instilled, ready for some history, based on the judicial law. That's why it's called the judicial system. Based on Judah, the tribe of Judah. Okay? Those are the commandments. Okay, the judicial system is based on that. If you think about it, the only difference is what Esau's, that's a big difference, but what Esau, the so-called white man, has done with the judicial system, listen up, is now for murder into the old covenant, you kill somebody, guess what, you were done. Now you gotta go in front of the jury of your peers. Now it's a whole show, and now you have murder first, murder second, murder third, you even got manslaughter. Okay, manslaughter is in the Bible, okay, because all manslaughter is that you kill somebody accidentally, okay, recklessly. Okay, in that time in the Bible, you had to flee, okay, for a certain amount of time. But now, it's all this mockery and kangaroo court that we're dealing with here, okay? But let me not digress from that. The bottom line is this, okay? You so-called Hispanics, Puerto Ricans, you better start to right now. And you too, brother, it's for you at this point now too, okay? We all, the Israelites, the Bible speaks. We all were enslaved together. That's Bible prophecy. Bring it up. Let me show you in the Bible that was prophecy. Listen to why slavery and everything happened to us. Because you may be wondering, all right, that kind of makes sense. But why? Why were we in these conditions?
In the Bible at all, why we are in different kinds of conditions?
Yeah, it does mention that, absolutely. Give me that. That's a very good question. The Bible covers everything. We're going to cover it right now.
I thought it was always just, that's why I say I don't believe in nationality. I thought it was just because it depends on the country, like if you were in a warmer climate, the skin protection from the UV rays.
Who taught you that?
I thought that myself.
No, but why'd you think that? Where'd you read that at? Who taught you that?
You know, because I heard that the skin is...
But who'd you hear it from? Who'd you hear it from, Tony?
Maybe one of History Channel or something.
Yeah, the so-called white man's channel. That's where you heard it from. Okay, that's nonsense. Go ahead. Hold on. The book of Hosea, chapter 7 and verse 8. Here's an answer to all your doubting that, why is some light skin, why a dark? Right here. Ephraim! He hath mixed himself among the people. We love the other nations. For some ungodly reason, we love the other nations. Okay? We hate ourselves as the bottom line. A lot of our people hate themselves. So they feel that if they go with the so-called white men or the other nations, they're gonna be loved and accepted. Okay? So that's why I say we are mixed. But also in addition to that, you have to understand something. That Abraham, who was our forefather, he had multiple different wives. So understand, like anything else. See, two black people can make a white kid and a dark kid. Two white kids. But a white and a dark kid can make a light and can make a dark. You follow what I'm saying? Jacob and Esau, that's exactly. Okay, case in point, Jacob and Esau, like the brother brought out. Okay, their parents, okay, were dark skinned. Okay, but one came out red, okay, meaning light, real red, and you can see the blood through. See, we got, so you gotta say something, we got color. Okay, we're not red. When we get sun, we may get a little amber at the beginning, but then it gets dark. You see our brothers and sisters out of Puerto Rico behind us, okay, they're dark skinned. Okay, now hey, read that.
Ephraim, he has mixed himself among the people.
So let's go ahead. Why we have different color skin? Go ahead.
Ephraim is a cake, not turd.
When you cook a pancake, the bottom is dark, right? How's the top look? Why does the Bible reference that? It's metaphor to show you who you are. Okay, go ahead.
Strangers have devoured his strength.
Now here's the reason why we don't know that we're the Israelites. Go ahead.
And he knoweth it not.
Strangers have devoured our strength. All the other nations throughout, remember, it's been hundreds, thousands of years that we were beat up. Right? Really, it really started really in 1492. We always knew who we were up until Columbus came. They devoured our strength, okay, through slavery, through separation, taking our children.
I had to both happen because I remember when David said that other nations has come together to tear bands asunder. So has other nations always been coming together to tear Israel apart? Or
all the other nations have always been confronted always part been of the Psalms 83.
Okay,
but hold your question, man. Let me get it. Hold your question.
Strangers have devoured his strength.
Strangers have devoured it. And this goes for the so-called black man too. A lot of them still don't know that they're the Israelites. Okay, go ahead.
And he knoweth it not.
And we know it not. Go ahead.
Yea, gray hairs.
Listen to this.
Gray hairs are there and here upon him. Yet he knoweth it not.
We got old timers. Okay, los viejos de nosotros. Okay, muchos de ellos saben. A lot of them know. Okay, but a lot of them don't. Okay, okay, go ahead. So, guess what? Now, if you have any doubt, because the best way to bring up objection, to handle objection is to bring it out. We're here to cover everything, and we're going to prove it in the Bible. Give me Hosea 9. If you have any doubt that you may be Spaniard, listen to this scripture right here. Okay, listen closely.
The book of Hosea, chapter 9, verse
13.
Ephraim, as I saw Tyrus, is planted in a pleasant place.
In a pleasant place. Where are we planted? Pleasant place. Puerto Rico's a pleasant place. Okay. Go ahead.
But Ephraim shall bring forth his children to the murderer.
Who's the murderer? Who's the murderer? The so-called Spaniard. Because remember, it said in the other scripture, our daughter's branches, the branches went over the wall. We mingled with the Spaniards, just like we do today. Right? But guess what? You are who your father is. So you may be thinking, well, if you are who your father is, then I may be Spaniard. Let's see what the Bible says.
Give them, O Lord, what wilt thou give?
What are we going to give to those people that we mix with? Okay, go ahead.
Give them a miscarrying womb.
A miscarrying womb. So guess what? Our sisters, a miscarriage. When you have a miscarriage, they lost the baby. The Most High basically killed the baby. Okay, guess what? Any little bit of Esau that try to come in, any little bit of so-called white man try to come in, it ain't coming in. Why?
Give them a miscarrying womb.
Because the Most High made sure that baby wasn't born. Okay, go ahead.
And dry breast.
And you need the breast, the milk breast, right? The milk from the breast to feed the kids. Just in case they were born, guess what? They were gonna die. So guess what? Okay, you are the Israelites, the Bible speaks of. Okay?